Hi, I'm Ronnie Turia. When I'm in town, I watch LTV with Alan and James.
You parle français.
Bonjour. Comment vas-tu?
Ça va et toi?
Très bien, merci et toi?
Surprise.
Yes, you're impressive there.
A little pear, eh? That's what kind you drink.
Well, we love Ronnie Turioff. He's got a great sense of humor, and he's enthusiastic, as I was saying, and things looked, though, very bleak for him a year ago. After being drafted the second round by the Lakers, it was discovered he would need an open-heart surgery to repair an enlarged aortic root. He wasn't expected back until sometime this season, yeah, at the earliest, but Turioff surprised everyone. He came back last year, and James sat down and talked with him about the positive energy when it comes to Turioff.
Nobody expected you to come back as fast as you did last year. This year you have a full season, and the power forward position is something that, you know, we really need, that rugged guy. And I saw that in you. What do you feel like your role is going to be this year in that position?
First and foremost, just to play hard, hustle, be the dirty guy. And I mean, I have no shame in saying that. I've said it last year, and that's what I want to be. That's who I want to be. Because I think every successful team, you have a guy that does a dirty job and nobody really talks about him or recognizes what he does. But in regard of his teammates know what he does.
You're the guy that gets people going. That's no secret about that. On the bench, you're very active, very animated.
I don't know. This is just part of me. I mean, I realized that last year when before the game, I used to do my little ritual and get the guys going. And one day, I was kind of tired. And the guy was like, Ronnie, what are you doing, man? This is when you're supposed to get us pumped up. So that's when I realized that I had some kind of effect on the guys, and I'm just trying as hard as I can to make those guys ready. So I think this is a neat thing, and I'm very proud to be a part of it.
Ronnie, growing up, was there anyone that you watched as a player that contributed to your enforcer role, if you will?
You guys are going to think I'm crazy, but I definitely look at Dennis Rodman. I mean, I remember being a little kid. I first started playing basketball, and I really didn't like doing it. And I was watching Dennis Rodman giving himself to his team, to his teammate, as far as not caring about scoring points, not caring about anything, but just giving his heart and everything on defense, getting offensive rebound, defensive rebound, playing tough defense. And that's something that I really appreciated it. And I think last year when I started playing and getting into that role of being the guy that just does the dirty work, I really realized that what he was doing was something pretty special.
Now, you know you look like a black leprechaun with that with that sweet beard. Now, is that the Ronnie trademark that we're going to see all year, or is it just a...
You know what? I'm thinking about I think I'm going to shave it to the side, and I think I'm going to keep that stuff trimmed, but I think that's a trademark for Ronnie this year.
That's an enforcer look, though,
you know,
man.
Like a wild guy. I'm going on the court, and I'm trying to scare people, you know, get them off Kobe and Lamar.
I love this guy.
Well, think about the odds of the tiny island of Martinique, and he winds up here and could be. How good do you think he can be?
He's good.
Put you on the spot.
He's good, and I think he's going to make a huge contribution. He's going to be the surprise this year coming off the bench. Rebounding the defense, critical.
Let's check.